Thank you. passed upon the stair. He spoke of was and when, although I wasn't there. He said I was his friend, which came as some surprise. I spoke into his eyes. I thought you died alone a long, long time ago. I roamed, I gazed a gazeless stare at all the millions here. We must have died alone a long, long time ago. You waiting, huh? What's up, guys? How you doing? Thanks for joining me for this little painting session I'm gonna do here. This is for a Hideo Kojima book. It is essentially a fan-created art book where a bunch of fans have just put different pieces of artwork and writings and all kinds of other things. The creator of the book wants to essentially, give this book to Hideo Kojima himself. So the way it all started, I guess I was one of the first people that he contacted, and then once from there, I got a little bit more attention. So essentially, this is my submission to the art book. So hopefully you enjoy it and get some good knowledge. Feel free to ask me any questions about what I'm doing, stuff like that. Right now, I'm working in Photoshop. So I'm going to eventually transition into a program called Paint Tool Sai to do some extra details. But right now, I'm just kind of... Let me just show you here. Oops, sorry. Let me just show you a little bit of what I've been doing here. So right here is my essentially my underpainting without any line work on top of it. So you can see it. And then underneath that, if you can see this, oops, that says jacket. So essentially underneath that, if you can see it, is his is my un, is my actual draw, my actual sketch that I originally did. So he over here. So that's pretty much it. I'm just gonna be detailing this up and making it look all nice. So hopefully you enjoy it. I'm gonna put some music on if you guys have any requests. I just have a whole Metal Gear-ish Police Knots Zone of Enders playlist here. So all right, so let's, I guess we'll start with kind of taken. Let me actually lower the music just a tad so I'm not getting drowned out. Hello? All right, sounds good. So far it's actually taken me about to do the rough painting. I started doing it last night, which was maybe about 2 hours. Oops, sorry. I'm using the space bar a lot, so. So it took about 2 hours to do this, to get everything roughed out. So right now I'm just going to be cleaning up a lot of my old stuff here. I have quite a. I use some reference and stuff here and there. I'm actually mostly using this piece of reference right here because it's somewhat in the same palette as my as the piece that I'm doing. No, the glasses actually are going to be, they're going to be on there. I just have them on a separate layer. Okay. And also the beard is also on a separate layer too. It just makes it a little easier for me to control what's going on with the actual piece. I'm probably going to do that later. Yes, I'll do up all the the different stuff, the different the glasses and everything on that later, but I just kind of want to get all of this out of the way first. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Nothing fancy. I'm kind of going for a Mad Max feel with this version. A lot of the guys that are doing the Kojima that have already submitted things and stuff, they're doing stuff that's very Shinkawa-esque. For this one in general, I wanted to go, kind of wanted to make it a little more Mad Max inspired. So if you notice, he's actually wearing Mad Max's jacket in this shot. The reason why I also separated the Yes, his hair is actually mirrored, but I'm not using. I used a different. I wanted it a different way. I'm wondering if he actually does it in different. I wonder if he does it in different style. I've seen him with his part in the other direction, so. And I feel like it works. The only reason why I have the reference photo open is actually just mostly for the structure of his face and a little bit of the lighting, because he's got a nice warm lighting on him, and I kind of want to go with that with my piece here. But in general, this is going to look very, my idea for it is it's going to look very Juice Drusen / Mad Max-ish. Also, his face is not facing, he's not facing forward in the reference. Sometimes I tend to use my own artwork. I tend to use the same palettes and stuff from my own artwork, so this is an old piece I drew of Snake. And that has a lot of the things that I'm gonna continue to be using in this image. So sometimes I'll just steal the color off of my own work. Once I'm done kind of detailing his face up a little bit, I'm gonna work on the glasses a little more. Because right now they're actually uneven. I'll put them on a separate layer because I wasn't sure if I wanted to give him the JF Ray glasses that he's got. You know, that he's worn multiple times, you know, during the promotion of Metal Gear Solid 5. But in the end, I just decided against it and just went with the kind of hard, you know, thick-rimmed glasses that he was wearing in one of the promotional videos that he did later for the new Kojima Production Studio. Right now I'm adding a little bit of a texture to my brush, kind of give it a little more of a painterly feel to it. Kind of gives this nice, like, dry brush effect on everything. See what else we got here. Right now I'm just kind of laying down stuff, not really doing too much. Just trying to get it ready for when I bring it over to the other program that I'm going to be using. And then once I get it over there, you know, I'll do a little bit more blending and smoothing, but right now I'm just kind of being short and sloppy with this. Hopefully, if all goes good, you'll probably see me finish this thing tonight. I don't have a lot to do to this. It's just about getting the detail up there. Guys are saying. Sorry if I can't see any. Oops. So if you look at how rough this right here, this snake that I did here is very, very rough. It's an example of like what my more rough speed paintings kind of look like. And then once I, you know, you can see for this Kojima piece where you can see the differences in what I'm doing. comes up next. Oh, you mean the Solid Zero book? As of now, I don't have any available. Now the orange and white in his hair is really just a quick backlighting that I'm gonna be doing on him. It's gonna be kind of an orangey piece. Just think Mad Max. Very brown, lots of browns and oranges. You'll see me popping back between the original sketch token, because there's some stuff that's getting pretty dark that I can't really see so well. Actually kind of weird seeing him without his glasses. That's it's just the best way I know to paint it. Once I get the glasses, to finalize the glasses, then I'll do some really cool shadow work on it and kind of get it to fit. It didn't look like it's actually sitting on the surface, sitting on its skin. But right now it's just about actually getting the, just getting these bits of different just getting it filled. And then once we're filled, painted most of the way, then I'm gonna take this thing over into paint tool side and do my finals. After that, I'll take it right back into Photoshop again and do some extra work on it. Right now I'm just solidifying these square shapes around the sides. Some of the tricks I tend to use is like to kind of cover space over. I'll use the smudge tool, which I'm getting right now, and I'll pull the color around, a little like oil paint. Right now I'm just doing the detail of the jacket. So let's turn off this. One thing about Photoshop that doesn't, I mean, it's a great program, but it's not really meant for actual, it's just the photo editing program that artists have, you know, adapted to use for actual painting or illustration work. So what you want, you know, I'm going to take this into a program that can actually do a lot of blending that you can get with doing, you know, with actual painting. You know, especially when you use oil paint, you get a lot of nice blending that happens, or just automatically, just by running your brush over the other paint, you get a lot of nice blending. But in Photoshop, you can't really do that. Good evening, grandfather. How are you? Welcome to my stream. I'll try to pull this out so I'm not boring you with details, so you can actually see what I'm working on as opposed to just seeing a portion of it. What, like a Mac or a PC? For hardware, on the, I'm using a PC. I'm using Photoshop. I mean, not Photoshop, but I'll be using a I had a pretty long day too, man. I have been preparing for C3, which is a comic convention in Chicago that I'm going to be at. I'm going to be selling some prints and doing all kinds of stuff, promoting my some of the comic books that I work on. It can be a little bit stressful, especially, you know, I mean, I just moved recently, and just to think about having to take a plane out of a state that you've never taken a plane out of is a little weird to me, but I think it'll be okay. you don't hear from me, then you'll know what happened. Just using this Photoshop and I'm using a PC. That's it. I have a pretty decent graphics card, so it can handle this stuff pretty well. I tried to make sure that I bought a system that can handle the work that I do from day to day. My day job is I do a lot of illustration and color work for comic books. And all this Metal Gear stuff I do kind of on my spare time when I'm when I'm not doing that stuff. I do a lot of color, you know, some of the color work I do. I've been doing a lot of color work as of late, so I haven't had a lot of chance to draw on my own or paint on my own. So it's just so I can, you know, a lot of this stuff is just to kind of get the creative stuff out of me. I mean, you can definitely be creative on somebody else's work, but at the same time, it's not actually the same. You know, there's nothing like actually going into your own work and doing. But what I do with a lot of the color work that I do is I try to treat their work like it's mine. So, you know, so it's, I like having synergy. I come from animation where, you know, you kind of have like a studio style and everybody works to kind of get that same style. And that's pretty much what I kind of bring to comics. I'm not really interested in trying to, I'm more interested in trying to create the moment rather than, you know, or scene, rather than try to just rehash a technique. And a lot of, you know, quite a bit of colorists tend to do that with it. In comics. They tend to have a technique that they do their books in, but they apply it to anybody. So like if it's sometimes you might be doing like a more stylized artist and they still try to do the same thing on them, which is not what you do. Each artist you work on in comics is a different voice, and you have to treat them like they're, you have to treat them all differently. That's at least my philosophy on doing color and comics and stuff. No, I'm using a Cintiq right now, which is a monitor that you can draw on. I used to use a tablet, actually not long ago. In fact, the first time I did one of these solid zero, you know, art streams, I was using a tablet. But I've since upgraded my old animation studio that I used to work at. They were selling a lot of their old Cintiqs off, so I managed to get it for a pretty decent price. Makes things a lot easier when you're able to actually see the work that you're doing. You know, it's like one-to-one, where the line that you draw on the screen is exactly what comes out, as opposed to kind of using your hand-eye coordination where you have your tablet on the side and you're looking at the screen. Cheap. They're very expensive. Granted, I guess they were upgrading or doing whatever, and what they did was they just sold me for the old prices, you know, for how much it was worth on the market right now. But other than that, yeah, it's an expense, and I don't suggest everybody get it, because it's so expensive to get your hands on. For me, I used a tablet for years. to me, it's not really about the tool. It's more about what you can do with that tool. For years before that, I used to do all of my artwork on using a mouse. So obviously these things make things a lot easier for you, but you don't. The tool isn't exactly what you make you make better artwork. It's you that'll make better artwork. It'll definitely make things easier for you, using a Cintiq or as opposed to a tablet. But you don't need it. Once you learn, it's just like anything else. It's just like hand-eye coordination, learning it. Learning to use a video game controller. It's pretty much the same sort of thing. How you use a mouse. Like that. To me, I never suggest to anybody to go out and go and get the best thing they can. I say get the best thing that you can afford. Work with that, and then when you have enough to afford the more expensive or the more, the better tech, then go for it. You don't need to go out and buy the ultimate tech. This is looking pretty decent. All right, so my roughs are pretty much done here. So what I'm gonna do now is take this thing into Sai. So save it. Almost didn't save it. All right. So that is Sai. Yeah, I wish I could. I'm actually using iTunes. Yeah. So right now I'm just gonna opening up this piece that I'm working on in another program called Sai. This one's actually a really great program. If you don't have a lot of money, you can invest in this program, which is only around $60. It's only around $60, and it does a lot of really great stuff. But what I like to do is sometimes I rather than open this thing up, I'll tend to go in and do everything up in Photoshop. At the time when I started this piece, I was working in Photoshop on another project, and I just speed painted it initially. I mean, about this program, there's really great stuff. Some nice kind of blend in, quickly blend in a lot of the things that I was doing before. Have a bit of a paper texture on this. Kind of give it a little, to just give it that more natural feel. Also, the other great thing about this program is that you can quickly rotate. I mean, you can do the same thing in Photoshop, but it's a little more of a hassle. By the way, guys, how's the stream working? Is it, are we, you know, everything seem clear and everything? You're not, you're not getting any hiccups or anything? I mean, I'm under a new internet service over here, so I don't exactly know what it looks like on your side. I mean, looking at the stream right now, and I see some pretty good stuff, but, yeah, let me know if you see, or if you hear any experiencing any technical issues. Perhaps I can fix it on my side. There's a lot of black in this corner. I'm gonna adjust that a little bit. I'm doing the painting a little bit of the painting no-no, which is essentially don't use black, but I really want to use. I really want this to kind of. This corner of his face to be really kind of deep and dark looking. Doesn't seem to fall right. Super well, like really captures all that. There's a lot of great old paint stuff. It's part of the reason why I like to use this to do paint work. Save this. Yes, it's fine. Yeah, sorry if I move the camera, you know, move the thing around, but what I, you know, sometimes, especially if you want to get like a certain sort of stroke on the screen, I like to, you know, I can either turn my tablet or I can just, you know, rotate the image really quickly to do the work. Because sometimes, you know, there's certain. When you're drawing, you kind of figure out your limits for your hand. So what areas, you know, you want to create like a really, you know, smooth line. You have to kind of know which way, when your hand will break. Because especially when you're inking, sometimes what will happen is that you'll get like a lot of waviness because you've kind of gone against your own arm. So what you do is sometimes what I'll do is I'll just rotate the canvas to get that stroke that I need to get. And that's, well, you know, I do that in real life too, on actual paper as well. One thing to know about, like, the way skin works is that it also reflects on itself. So when you always see something, a good example, I'm not sure if you can see, but like, you can't probably see it because my little graphic in the corner is green, but whenever you put like two warm objects next to each other, the shadow always, one thing always reflects onto the other. So if you notice, like sometimes if you put your hand next to a red wall, you know, say you're getting reflected light from the red wall, that's because, you know, obviously light reflects everywhere, and it also reflects on different wavelengths. So sometimes, especially when you're standing on green grass, you get a little bit of the reflected light of the green grass. If your nose over your mouth, you know, also gets reflected light from your own skin. So underneath your nose, you probably get a little bit more red, or a little more, you know, a little bit more warmer color. So what happened? So like with like something like this, like if you notice me under here, under the nose, I'm trying to get that little bit of red that happens there. Also, you know, due to the translucency of skin, you get a little bit of red, especially under certain lighting conditions. Funny, I see this picture of him with this, you know, this picture I'm doing of Mr. Kojima in this leather jacket. There's this old shot of him that I saw. I think it's from like the 60s or something like that. And he's wearing a leather jacket and he's got this big, like, 60s, 70s hair. It's pretty cool. So guys, I will be right back. I'm just going to get myself a little bit of dinner, and from there I will continue, you know, on from where I left off. So, so I'll be right back. I'll just put my little be right back logo up, and I'll see you in a bit. Well, hello. Hello. Sorry, I just had some dinner.
Thank you.
There's only four of you. I guess you guys got bored. I know art could be a little bit boring. Ahem. go. See what you guys are up to over there. Ah, yes, nice and quiet. Wonderful day to end. Wonderful time to end the day, right? Let's see.
Thank you.
way. Thank you. I'm just about finished working on his face. Now, you know, I already kind of did up his suit here, his leather jacket. So after this, I'm going to go in and do up his facial hair, which you'll see here, which I will keep on a separate layer. And then I'm going to go in and do up his glasses. And then do some shadow work on his glasses on his face. It should look real cool. But he looks like himself even without his glasses, and that's good. Alrighty. So how's everybody going in there? Everybody doing okay? Getting a little close, getting pretty close to finishing this thing off. I gotta do shadows on Mr. Kojima's eyes. And then, I think I'm done. Beard or no beard, glasses or no glasses. Alright, let's give this a little bit of something in here. Thank you. So I think that's a finished deal right there. So I think that's it. Guys, thank you for joining me for this one. Here is the final piece. Actually, no. There's actually going to be a little bit more I'm going to do on this. But I'm going to take this thing right back into Photoshop. So, hold on. But yes, all the heavy work has been done on this now. And then I'm going to separate this, you know, cut this background that it has on there and do a couple more things on it. And I think it's going to be a done deal. For those of you who've just come in, this is for the Hideo Kojima book, which is a fan project created by a very big fan of the Metal Gear Solid games and Mr. Kojima. He asked me to do this, you know, to do anything for the project, so I decided to draw Kojima as kind of Mad Maxy, you know, with his cool looking jacket and everything. I decided to go with something a little bit different on this, you know, for this piece. Usually, if you're familiar with my work on Twitter and DeviantArt, I usually do, you know, something that looks a little bit more Shinkawa-esque when I do some Metal Gear stuff. But for this one, I wanted to do something a little bit more in the lines of like a Drew Struzan or maybe you know, some of the old Mad Max cover posters and stuff. I decided to put, you know, to have a, give him a removable beard, for those of you who don't like beards. And also, he has a removable pair of glasses. And yeah, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do some more little bits of detail work, you know, so I can... Some more little bits of detail work here and there, like on the hair and stuff. Try to get everything right, and then after that I'm going to take this right back into Photoshop and do some texture working on this, because I feel like it needs a little bit of that. So, you know, if you have any questions about any of the work that you've seen here, or, you know, stuff like that, don't hesitate to ask, because also, if you're all interested, any of you guys are interested in my work, you can head over to my Twitter, which is emanland at Twitter, at emanland. Also, you can go on to my DeviantArt. You also can see me, and pretty much this weekend I'm going to be at C2E2, so, which is a comic convention out in Chicago. time to take this back into Photoshop. Try 15. Right now I'm just making that. I want to have a white background on this piece, so I'm removing my brown canvas here. So yes, remove the glasses and beard. Okay. So now I'm going to add a texture to this. Okay. Now, what I like to do is I add, sometimes I'll add a little bit of a noise texture or a film grain to everything to kind of give it that papery feel. So that's what I'm doing right now. Tend to turn down the saturation, so it's a little gray. So then when I throw it on top, you'll notice that it gets a little bright. So then what we'll do is do little levels, turn it down a bit, and then what we do is turn this down so that so it still has the same quality of the original. Maybe a little more. Here we go. Maybe we'll do a little more levels. Okay. That works. So now we'll put a little background on this. A little white background. And there you go. So this may or may not be a cover. I don't exactly know what the plan is behind to do with this piece for the book. All I know is I was supposed to make something that he wanted me to do anything I wanted to do. So I decided to draw this. Other than that, I mean, it was just, I wanted to do Mad Max Kojima. That's pretty much it. No big ideas behind it exactly. Hopefully, once the book is out, you guys get to see what the whole thing is. The Kojima book, I think it's going to be a very, very limited run from what he says, and that it will only be, I think he's only going to make like a one-off and maybe one for all the folks that contributed artwork to the book. So I don't think it's going to be widely available. I'm sure, especially since the book has a lot of artwork that is Konami centric, that it might, of course he doesn't want to start mass producing it, which I can totally understand. So yeah. All right, there's only three of you left. So I want to thank you all for joining me for this one. Hope to see you again for another bit of art and stuff. So all right, guys, see you later.